Whether you're planning to go into the world of science, economics, engineering, or just simply want to strengthen your analytical skills, pre-calculus offers tools that will help you sharpen the way you think and solve problems. Pre-calculus is a bridge that connects algebra and geometry that you've learned so far to the world of calculus. Calculus is mathematical study of continuous change. In the same way, geometry is the study of shape, and algebra is the study of generalization of arithmetic operations. In Latin, the word calculus means small pebble. In ancient Rome, such pebbles were used for counting out distances, tallying votes, and doing abacus arithmetic, so the word became a Latin word for calculation. Modern calculus was developed in 17th century Europe by Isaac Newton and Gottfried Wilhelm Leibniz, independently of each other, first publishing around the same time. But the elements of it appeared in ancient Egypt and later Greece. Physics, which is a 12-grade science course, makes particular use of it, as all concepts, from classical mechanics to electromagnetism, are related through it. In this course, we will cover functions and their graphs, polynomial and rational functions, exponential and logarithmic functions, trigonometry, sequences and series, and intro to limits. Before we begin with the new lesson materials, let's revise the things you've learned in the previous grades. Here are a couple of problems you can solve for practice. Question number 1. Simplify the expression. 3 multiplying x minus 2 in the parentheses plus 2 multiplying x plus 5 in the parentheses. To simplify this expression, we have to use the distributive property and multiply 3 by x and then by negative 2 in the parentheses. We will do the same thing for the second parentheses and multiply 2 by x and then by positive 5. Next step would be to combine like terms. 3x and 2x are like terms, so by combining them we would get 5x. Negative 6 and positive 10 are also like terms, so by combining them we would get positive 4. So the final solution would be 5x plus 4. Question number 2. Expand and simplify. X plus 3 in the parentheses multiplying x minus 4. In this question, we would also have to use the distributive property. We need to multiply x from the first parentheses by each term in the second parentheses. And then we would do the same thing for positive 3. Multiplying x by x would give us x squared. Multiplying x by negative 4 would give us negative 4x. 3 multiplying x would give us positive 3x, and 3 multiplying negative 4 would give us negative 12. Our next step is combining like terms, negative 4x and positive 3x. And we would get the final answer, x squared minus x minus 12. Third and final problem is a bit more challenging. Evaluate the function. F of x is equal to 2x squared minus 3x plus 1 for x equals negative 2. The only thing we have to do is substitute x with negative 2. So whatever we see x in the function, we just write negative 2. That would give us 2 multiplying negative 2 squared minus 3 multiplying negative 2 plus 1. The order of operations states that the first thing we have to simplify here is the exponent, negative 2 squared. Negative 2 squared is equal to positive 4. So 2 times positive 4 minus 3 times negative 2 plus 1 should later be equal to 2 times 4 giving us 8, negative 3 times negative 2 giving us positive 6, and plus 1. The final answer would be 15. That's all for today. Make sure to follow and subscribe to our channel, and see you in the next lesson.